Hello folks, welcome again to another session on polynomials, and in continuation with whatever we were doing, we will be doing graphs of linear polynomials today. In the previous sessions, we have seen definition of polynomials, different types of polynomials, and in the last session, we discussed zeros of a polynomial, isn't it? Now, in this session, we are going to discuss graphs of linear polynomials. How do we draw graphs? And you must have, you know, learned drawing graphs in your previous grades, where we will be doing graphs on a two-dimensional plane, and it is called Cartesian coordinate system, which we will be using. And we will, in this session, try to learn how to plot linear polynomials on a graph. Now, what is a linear polynomial? Linear polynomial, I have shown three forms here. So one is px equals to ax plus b. This is the way you describe a linear polynomial. Y is equal to mx plus c is another way of describing linear polynomials, which is in coordinate geometry terms, we called it slope-intercept form. Slope-intercept form. And this is the most standard form, this one. Ax plus by plus c is the standard form of a linear polynomial. Standard form. And it is also the standard form of a linear equation, isn't it? So let us now understand how to plot a linear polynomial like px equals to ax plus b. Now, to do that, what we do is we first of all take some values of x and the corresponding values of px we find out. So we, in the previous sessions, we have learned how to find out values of polynomials. So hence you take some values of x and some values of, you know, corresponding values of y, which is nothing but our px. So you find the values of px, and hence we will be getting ordered pair, which will be the coordinates of the points lying on this polynomial representation on the graph. So let us start with x equals 0. So let us say if x equals to 0, then clearly px is equal to b. It will be better, let us say, if we take an example and then describe, and then we can always generalize. So let me say our equation is, or our polynomial is, px is equal to 2x minus 3. Okay, so hence let us now plot some points. Let us say this is x and this is my px, or which is nothing but y. So let us say x is equal to 0, then what is px? Px is clearly minus 3, isn't it? Now let us say if x equals to 1, then px is clearly minus 1, and if x is, let us say, 2, px is 4 minus 3, that is 1. So hence, if you see, for every change of 1 unit in x, we are getting 2 unit of change in y or px. So here again, the difference is 1, and here again, the difference is 2. This is the peculiar behavior of a linear polynomial. Okay, you can try some negative values as well. So let us say x is equal to minus 1, then if you see, what will be the value of px? Px will be nothing but minus of 5, right? So now how to do that? So this is how we plot. You have already learned how to plot a graph. So let us say this is my y-axis, and this is x-axis. Okay, this is x and this is y. And let us say this is how we are. So let us say 1 unit is, or 2 units equals 1 unit here. So I'm just drawing it roughly, and we can definitely go to a tool like GeoGebra and plot it accurately as well. So let us first see how this curve would behave, or this linear polynomial will behave. So I interchangeably use the words like curves and polynomials and all that. So what is it? Polynomial in algebra can be seen as a curve in geometry. Yeah, so they are same or similarly explained. Now, so this point is 0, 0, so you know the origin is 0, 0. Now 0, -3, so 0 is the x coordinate, minus 3 is y coordinate. So if you see, this is minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. So let us say this is negative y, isn't it? So hence somewhere here is 0, -3. And then there is one point like 1, -1, -1. So where are those points? Like 1, -1. Where is this point? So this is 1, and -1 is somewhere here. Let us say -1 would be somewhere. 1, -1 is this. Similarly, 2 comma 1 would be somewhere here, and minus 1 comma minus 5 would be somewhere here. So if you see, if you now join them with freehand, you will see that all of them fall on a line, and hence this is called a linear polynomial, right? So this is a polynomial for px is equal to 2x minus 3. Okay, so let us see this exactly in our GeoGebra tool. So please remember, we have to plot 0 comma minus 3. So these are the points: 0 comma minus 3, 1 comma minus 1, 2 comma 1, and minus 1 comma minus 5. Okay, so let us go to the GeoGebra tool and plot them there and see what kind of graph we get. So here is the GeoGebra tool, and now we are going to plot the points which we discussed. So let us plot the points, and the points are nothing but this is how you should be actually able to plot. So points are what were the points like when 0 comma minus 3, isn't it? 0 comma minus 3. Okay, so this is the first point. Let me press enter, and we have got one point. It is here, A. Can you see that? A, correct. Let us plot the other points. Let us say it was 1 comma minus 1. So 1 comma minus 1, okay, and here is point B. Let us plot now 2 and 2 comma 1, right? So point is 2 comma 1, right? So 2 comma 1 is C. So you see it is there. Then let us plot 3 minus 1 comma minus 5, is it? The last point was minus 1 minus 1 comma minus 5, right? So if you see, it looks like all of these lines are falling on the straight line. So let me try and join them. So with a line, so I am joining these point. Sorry, it got displaced. So wait a minute. Yeah, so now let me join this select. Yeah, so 1 and 2. If you see, I selected these two points, and if you observe, all the points so made are now lying on this particular line. What, once again, I'm going to draw it, this one and this one. So here it is, right? So if you see, this is the line which is passing through all the four points which we just found out. So this is how linear polynomial will behave. So if you put if you see, another observation is as x is very, very small, that is, it goes towards minus infinity, y is also very, very small, and as x is increasing, y is increasing, and the concept of zero is also there. So if I have to point out the concept of the zero is here, point e, where the value of px is becoming zero, right? So point e here is the zero of this polynomial, and its value is 1.5 if you see it right now. This is how a polynomial behaves when shown in a graph. Now another thing which I wanted to show you is, in a general case, let us say if I had a general case, for example, I'm now going to show you a general case, right? So if you see, I had shown you y is equal to ax plus b. Now what happens if I change the value of a and b? So let us first change the value of a and see how the curve behaves, isn't it? So our intention is to see how the curve behaves when I change the value of a. So look carefully. Now I am increasing the value of a. So if you see, the moment I increase the value of a, what happens? The curve or the line starts rotating around a point, isn't it? Around a point. Now let me also point out this. So this point is g. As I am changing the value of a, the line is rotating around the point g, right? This is what happens. So if you see, actually this point a is close to the slope, it's called the slope. So slope is nothing but how much is inclined is the line with the x-axis. So if you see, as I'm increasing the slope value a, the inclination of the line with the x-axis is increasing, and as I'm decreasing the value of a, the inclination of this line with x-axis is decreasing. So that's how a line will behave. Now secondly, if I now change the value of b, what happens? So if you see, I'm increasing the value of b, so its distance from y-axis is actually increasing, and I am reducing the value of B, the distance, or it is, you know, just the curve is getting shifted upwards and downwards depending upon the value and sign of B. Now, one special point is when B is equal to 0. If you see B, I am making B is equal to 0. So, what happens when B becomes 0? So, let me just make, yes, B as 0. So, if you see, now B is equal to 0. In this case, the line is passing through origin. If you see, line is passing through origin. Actually, the B, here the parameter B is called the y-intercept. Y-intercept. So, y-intercept is nothing but the distance of the point where the line is cutting the y-axis from the origin. So, if you see now B is 1. That means, B is 1 means it is 1 unit. The point where the line is cutting the y-axis, that is G, is 1 unit away from the x-axis, right? So, this is how. So, now I am going to show you if both A and B are moved together. So, what happens, right? So, see, now both A and B are moving together and this is how the line is behaving, right? This is how the line is behaving. The line is changing the direction of the rotation, as in it is rotating first of all, and then it is also going up and down, up and down in along the y-axis, right? So this is what happens when you change the value of, let us say, A and B. I hope you understood what are the parameters A and B, what are their importance. In fact, in general slope intercept form, it is called y is equal to mx plus c. If I have to make a note here, so y is equal to actually mx plus c, where m here in this case is a, so this is ax plus b. In this case we have taken a and b, but in terms of coordinate geometry in that language we talk about m and c, where m is a and c is b, and this m is called slope, right? So as you change the value of slope, the inclination of the line from the x-axis keeps changing, and this particular thing is called y-intercept, where it is the distance of the point of intersection of y-axis with the line from the origin.